Chinee Ogwumike. I'm from Stanford University, and I'm here studying abroad in Nigeria.
What are you studying in Stanford?
At Stanford, I'm an international relations major, which makes pretty much sense. And I'm a focus, primary specialization is in Africa, and the secondary specialization is in comparative international governance.
You're talking about sports. What's your level of participation in sports, especially basketball?
In basketball, I was recently a two-time All-American at Stanford University, defending Pac-12 Offensive and Defensive Player of the Year. Our team won the Pac-12 Championship. We've made a history of going to Final Fours, even though in the NCAA tournament we stopped at the Sweet 16, but we had a great year. A challenging year, but we made a lot of great memories at Stanford, which is in California.
Now, a lot of Nigerians or Nigerian-Americans who do well overseas, when they are invited to play for the national team, some of them feel there's no point representing the country. What's your take on this?
It's really interesting to me. I have an older sister who is a very successful athlete. She was the number one draft pick of the WNBA draft last year, and she now currently plays for the Los Angeles Sparks. And she was invited at the young age to play, but at that time she hadn't even known the game very well. But surprisingly, I haven't really been invited. I think they just assume, since I was born and raised in Houston, Texas, which I was, and I am so enthralled with the United States and the sports system there, that, you know, I would not want to. But at the same time, I understand that mindset. My opportunities came from the U.S. I made a lot of great memories playing sports there, and I have great connections with the USA Basketball organization, so I like representing the United States. I'm just getting to know Nigeria. So I think that it's an honored and humbling honor for me to be invited to play. But I'm just starting to get to know the country of my mother and my father. So I'm very excited for my position right now in the U.S. and, you know, to inspire people here in Nigeria, too.
So how would you describe your stay so far in Nigeria?
It's been wonderful. I've been working pretty hard. I recently shadowed in the Ministry of Petroleum, and I also have worked in the National Assembly, so I'm dabbling in a lot of things, but it's been wonderful. I think it's great for any student to, you know, get outside of their country where they're residing and learn something new about a place you don't know. So I know this place. I've been educated from my parents in Houston, Texas. My dad works out here quite frequently, so I've been educated about Nigeria, but getting to experience this for myself as a young woman, a place that has so much culture that I identify with, has been remarkable.
So how much of basketball do you know in Nigeria?
I know quite a bit. I was so excited to see Team Nigeria qualify in the London Olympics, the men's team. I was rooting for them and rooting for the United States, because for a continent so dominated by football, soccer, I think it was a great moment for African sports to see another sport really shine. So I was really excited for them. I know it was a tough loss against the U.S., but, you know, the strides they made, I think they have the first National Basketball League, the DSTV League, going on really in Lagos, that I hope to see games there too. So it's just a really exciting time for basketball around the world.
So how do you see the development of the game in Nigeria and in generally in Africa?
In Africa, and specifically in Nigeria, I think the steps they're making right now with the league, with promoting more facilities like this, having kids getting access to play, more instructional leaders coming back to Africa to teach people that are willing to learn, I think only from then the sport will grow, and only then will Africa and other countries around the world be more competitive on the world scene. And I think that's why little strides are made every year or every 4 years, as we see in the Olympics.
Well, do we need to say more? We have to act very quickly if we want to get this pretty lady to play for Nigeria, or we just lose her forever to the States.
You said pretty, you didn't say talented.
You meant say talented?
yeah. I know, she's pretty talented, yeah, if you put it that way. So.
Yeah, we'll talk about the main issue now.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, when you talk
about the main, I really like...
This man was kind of doing the interview.
Yeah, obvious.
Talk about the main issue.
No, Koike has been trying to get her contact since then.
I did no such thing.
Okay, but let's talk about the issue now.
I think she's talented, you know, and we need such players for Nigeria. You know, for me, I've ruled the way we missed Alaba of Bayern Munich. A great player. A top quality player. So if we have...
Like we don't do our scouting well enough.
We don't do our scouting well.
I mean, now that this game is in Nigeria...
I think we are so much engrossed with our problems here that we can't see beyond the shores of this country. We need to start solving our problems here so that we can start...
And attracting them too.
Exactly.
If I may say something, it's the problem is that we are too we are too short-sighted. We don't see the bigger picture. We don't see the resources that we have. For example, the general manager of the Denver Nuggets is a Nigerian, Masai Ujiri, born and bred here.
Yeah, NBA executive
of the year 2012. This man has extensive
contacts in the NBA
in Africa.
Masai Ujiri has always been in,
yes,
contributing his own contact to the NBA.
But he's been doing that in an informal role.
Yeah.
He has never really had contact with the Nigerian Basketball Federation here, and there's an official line of communication open between them.
So we can tap whatever we can, and that's
basketball. We have Mike Emenalo in England. We have other coaches and officials spread around the world.
Do they want to have contacts with them? That's the issue. Do they want to have
big question? Big question.
All right, let's move on. Of course, I'm sure that by now, the authorities should have identified that. Look.